Since the Surface Duo launched in 2020, I've been fascinated with the weird complexity surrounding DS, 3DS, and Wii U emulation on handheld devices. None of that complexity is necessarily due to how demanding the systems are to emulate. Any reasonably performant device can handle all three systems these days, as long as an emulator exists for the device's platform, of course. However, the fact that most devices on the market these days only have a single screen means that using those devices often comes with the trade-off of squished gameplay, off-center virtual displays, or control schemes that are less than ideal. No shade to the folks who don't care about any of those trade-offs, just for those of us looking to have the full experience of dual-screen games, squeezing everything onto a single display isn't gonna get you there. Yet, I also understand that many of the best options to get the best experience aren't necessarily mainstream yet. That's why, in this video, let's spend some time looking at what the current hardware is for portable DS, 3DS, and Wii U emulation so that when you do go looking for the full experience, you know what options you have to choose from. Before we dig into hardware recommendations, let me start with the simple truth underlying dual-screen emulation today. Original hardware will always have a leg up over the currently available options. While processing power of newer devices has eliminated many of the drawbacks of emulation, not all games run perfectly 100% of the time in emulation. There are also an abundance of features on the original hardware, like more integrated online experiences and having the exact control scheme intended for each game, which you're likely not going to get with all the available options at this point in time. Stereoscopic 3D gameplay is especially rare outside the 3DS at the moment, which sucks since it actually is key to certain gameplay, improves the perceived resolution of many games, and generally makes game environments look more dynamic. Among portable hardware, there are a few 3D display-equipped laptops on the market, as well as the Red Hydrogen 1, all of which aren't perfect recreations of the 3DS's stereoscopic display. VR headsets like the Quest 3 can also offer some 3D features, but fall far short in the realm of controller experience. All of which is to say, if you want stereoscopic 3D, a 3DS is your only decent option. Though possibly more important than any of what I just mentioned, original hardware will also be cheaper than any of the emulator options I'll point to in this video. At the moment, here in the US, a 3DS can be sourced for just over $100 if you're patient, and Wii U's are about the same price. Proper dual-screen emulation isn't necessarily for the most price-conscious folks at the moment. If any of this makes you wary, spend the cash to go get yourself a new 3DS XL and Wii U to get the most out of what their respective libraries have to offer. You're gonna have a great time. Although, before you jump from this video to eBay to buy some very old tech, know that there are more than a few reasons why folks like me wade through these downsides to emulate games. For me, the main three reasons are: 1, I can play many of the games in my library at higher than native resolutions on much bigger, much better displays than original hardware. 2, I can add cheat codes and modifications to games to change up gameplay or improve some of the downsides of the original experience. And 3, it's much easier to maintain a large library of ROMs within an emulator than on the original system. And having a single device that can play Wii U, 3DS, and DS games in the first place is impossible with original hardware. Even as someone who loves his DS, 3DS, and Wii U collections to death, having the versatility to easily re-experience many of my favorite games in new ways is something that I really prize. And honestly, it might be something worthwhile for most folks to give a shot if they're interested in returning to dual-screen systems. Okay, now that that's out of the way, let's talk about hardware. In general, you can separate proper hardware for dual-screen emulation into two camps: those that can emulate Wii U games and those that can't. Or, more directly, those running desktop OSs like Linux and Windows, and those running Android. I'm going to start with the Android side of things because it's actually the most straightforward right now. Currently, the three best Android-equipped options on the market are the Surface Duo 2, Surface Duo 1, and LG V60. The Surface Duo 2 has the most performant hardware of the three, with a Snapdragon 888 inside. Using Drastic and Citra MMJ, it has excellent performance for DS and 3DS emulation, respectively. Better yet, its dual 4x3 OLED displays are the perfect size to display DS games and almost perfect for 3DS games. Outside original hardware, it's one of the few devices on the market that won't result in giant black bars around the sides of gameplay without resorting to weird stretching. All you need to add is a clip-on controller, either USB-C or Bluetooth will do, and it's a hyper-compact experience that elevates visuals beyond the LCDs in my 3DS XL. That's all while still having the same footprint as a 3DS XL, with half the depth. From all the dual-screen implementations I've tested so far, it's hard to get better than what's on display here. Unfortunately, you're also bound to pay quite a lot for this experience. Here in the US, on eBay, I'm seeing Surface Duo 2s in working condition going for about $600. That's quite a bit less than the $1,500 I paid for mine a couple years ago, but also well within the enthusiast range of prices for someone just looking for any dual screen emulator. Fortunately, both the Surface Duo 1 and LG V60 exist for about a third of the price with very similar functionality, albeit with a few added drawbacks. The Surface Duo 1 has the same shape as the Duo 2, just a bit lighter, due to the lack of an external camera. Additionally, it packs a less performant Snapdragon 855 chipset, which will still be fantastic for DS emulation, but slightly less than ideal for 3DS emulation. Add in the fact that the USB-C port is off-center on the Duo 1, and it is basically an older Duo 2 that requires a few more considerations from users. Meanwhile, the LG V60, with its dual-screen case, takes a different approach altogether. Instead of the big, beautiful 4x3 displays on the Duos, it has a much more standard slab phone shape, powered by the slightly newer Snapdragon 865. It can emulate both DS and 3DS games much more comfortably than the Duo 1, but also has large black bars around gameplay, which is perfect for touch controls, but less than ideal if you'd rather add a physical controller. Though, on the topic of physical controls, it's also one of the largest slab phones I've ever used, and doesn't fit into the clip-on controllers I have on hand. Wider clip-on controllers are a necessity here. The lack of a USB-C port on the case also means that anyone using it will need to source a Bluetooth controller instead of a standard USB-C controller. While large Bluetooth clip-on controllers are uncommon, there are at least a few quality options that have just hit the market. Altogether, if you're looking for an Android solution, it comes down to two real questions. What's your budget, and do you care about black bars? If your budget's high enough, the Surface Duo 2 will be one of the best dual-screen Android experiences money can buy. If your budget's lower and you don't care about the V60's black bars or awkward size, it'll also give you a fantastic dual-screen emulation experience that only marginally lags the Duo 2 in performance. Meanwhile, if you really want the gameplay to look as close as possible to the original displays, but can't afford a Duo 2, well, the Surface Duo 1 rounds out the rear as a fantastic option that also won't break the bank, especially if you're willing to get one with some slight cosmetic damage. If you're interested in more info on each of these devices, I'll also have links in the video description to videos I've done on each in the past. Okay, so for one last thing before I move on from Android, there are a couple more non-traditional options which might also be helpful to know about. Mainly, folding screen phones. Folding screens have gotten super popular over the past few years due to their massive screen real estate. Newer phones with the latest chipsets will have better raw performance than the Duo 2, but come with the same large black bar caveat as the LG V60, if touch controls aren't enough. For certain folks, having a handheld mini tablet will likely be more than enough space to stack a couple screens. It's just worthwhile to note that there's a certain level of gameplay awkwardness to doing away with the physical hinge for these setups. The inability to tilt the main display toward me changes how I hold the device and where my eyes should be looking at any given time. I personally find it less comfortable overall. For extra context, it's very reminiscent of the original 2DS, which I also wouldn't recommend for someone looking to get into dual screen gaming for the first time anyway, due to its controls. But if you enjoy the extra utility of folding screen phones for other reasons, it could be worthwhile to give it a shot. Okay, moving on from Android. Anyone looking for a dual-screen Wii U emulation will need much more performant hardware, or at least hardware not running on an ARM-based processor. From a portability standpoint, that's going to mean handheld PCs, which is where dual-screen gaming has recently gotten pretty interesting. Unlike with Android, it's actually not necessary to buy a dual-screen computer to get the full experience for dual-screen games on a handheld PC. That's because it's fairly easy to take whatever handheld PC you have and mount a second display onto it, including your smartphone. I've made a ton of videos on this topic before, links will be in the video description if you're interested in a full setup guide, but the gist these days is that you should look for a handheld PC that's relatively flat and wide and is powerful enough to emulate Wii U games, usually a Steam Deck or better. You can then get a display mount and attach it to your PC, connect some cables, and get playing. I've designed some mounts in the past, but my current favorite for my Steam Deck is Mechanism's phone mount, combined with their DeckMate grip. Magnetic puck attaches to the magnets on my Pixel 8 Pro's D-brand Ghost case without a fuss and allows ample room for cable management. This arrangement with my Pixel, or other slap phones, is more than good enough for games like Mario Kart 8, where the gamepad view provides important information, but nothing that I need to actively interact with. Alternatively, if you'd like the full experience, a folding screen phone can make touch-heavy gamepad interactions a bit easier due to its fantastic ability to stand in as a main display. Of course, handheld PCs aren't cheap. A new LCD Steam Deck will set you back about $400 these days. However, I imagine most folks attempting a setup like this will either already own a handheld PC or be looking to buy one for other reasons. If that's you, the real price of entry is only about $40 for the phone mount and the price of whatever extra adapters you need to connect your phone, all of which I'll have linked in the video description. If all this seems like a ton of work and you just want something to pick up and play, I totally get it. Luckily, there's at least one handheld PC on the market that'll make setup a lot easier. The iNeo Flip DS. This true dual-screen handheld feels and plays just like a 3DS XL with just a little more bulk. It has a very nice 1080p 120Hz LCD main display that makes most 3DS and Wii U games look much better on it than original hardware. It's my current primary device for PC gaming, and I couldn't recommend it enough for anyone wanting the best handheld money can buy for either 3DS or Wii U emulation. Unfortunately, with great ability comes great cost. The base model Flip DS costs twice as much as an LCD Steam Deck with only a moderate boost to performance. There's also some awkward software shenanigans with iNeo's iOSpace implementation. Add in the current awkwardness of DS emulation on Windows, for which you'll really want an external mouse to set up on this device, and there are some real downsides that prospective buyers will need to contend with. Even still, I've yet to use any other device outside original hardware that feels quite as good for dual-screen gaming as the Flip DS. If you're interested in learning more, I did a full review on this device a few weeks ago. I'll have a link to that in the video description. Both attaching a screen mount to a handheld PC and the Flip DS basically cover the extent of portable hardware you'll want to consider for dual-screen Wii U emulation at the moment. However, if you wanted to go a step deeper, it's also worth noting that both Lenovo and Asus have full dual-screen laptops available on the market. Considering they both use Intel's integrated graphics, they likely won't be the most performant options for gaming, and you'll definitely need an external controller for both. But the form factor could be just right for anyone interested in larger displays and the productivity benefits of dual screens outside gaming. Okay, let's wrap up this video with just a general summary of everything. First up, should you go Android or handheld PC? If you aren't interested in Wii U gaming at all, the Duo 2, Duo 1, and LG V60 are all fantastically portable devices that'll get you close to the experience of a 2DS XL with an abundance of extra features. Alternatively, if Wii U emulation is a must, the Aya Neo Flip DS is just about the best option on the market for easy, comfortable gameplay. However, for those without deep pockets, strapping a second screen to something like a Steam Deck also works quite well. Still, as much as I love nerding out about dual screen tech, I would be doing y'all a disservice if I didn't stress practicality for such large purchases. All else being equal, it can also be extremely helpful to ask yourself what else you would plan to do with your new dual screen machine. Handheld PCs are fantastic at working through a Steam library, meanwhile Android devices are better for cloud gaming due to their ability to connect to cell networks. Android devices are also more flexible with controllers if you want to change up gameplay feel, whereas handheld PCs are full-on miniature laptops that can be docked to external displays. There are really no bad choices here. Just make sure to go with something that'll give you your money's worth, especially when you decide to play more than dual screen games. Those have been my thoughts though. Now's the time when I ask for yours. Do you have a favorite dual screen emulation device you'd recommend to folks new to the scene? Or are you yourself new to dual screen emulation and have questions you'd like to ask? Let me know down in the comments. As always, if you found this video helpful or informative, go ahead and give it a like to let me know. Then get subscribed for more dual screen gaming videos in the very near future. Like I've said throughout this video, there are a ton of links in the description to other videos I've created on the devices described in this video. I've way too many dual screen devices in my collection and would be happy to answer any additional questions y'all have just down in the comments. But anyway, that's gonna be all for this video. Thank you so much for watching all the way until the end. I hope this video provided you with some solid ideas for your next dual screen gaming session. But until next time, catch you later.